It's been a tough few months for our Australian workforce between announcements of car manufacturing ending, our highest unemployment rates in a decade, and most recently the 5,000 jobs to go from Qantas. All of this is causing incredible stress and anxiety to workers over their job security.
To talk to us more about that feeling of anxiety, of losing your job, we've got organisational psychologist Jasmine Sligger is here, and also social demographer Mark McCrindle. Guys, thanks for being here this morning.
Hi, how are you?
Good morning.
Let's start with you, Jasmine. I mean, you would speak to a lot of people who are about to lose their jobs, who have just lost their jobs. The people who are about to lose their jobs, what's their mindset like knowing that they're going to have such a big change coming down the pipe?
Well, they're just about to have a reaction, which is like a shock. It's like grief. So one of the things that's going to happen is they're going to be really nervous. I'll lose the house. What am I going to do with the kids who are in private school or whatever? So our role is really to calm them down, to really kind of assess their personality to see, are they overthinking things? Because some people really overthink things. And so we have to really look at how prepared are they. I always encourage people to have their resumes ready every year. Redo your resume, everybody, every year. Because it gives you an opportunity to inspire yourself about really the gifts that you do have that you bring to work.
How destabilizing and how much effect does it have on people emotionally and physically, the fact that a lot of this is completely out of their control? They're being made redundant or sacked, not because they're not good at their job, but because of issues with management or different things that are out of their control.
Yeah, it's a huge emotional shock, and it really is devastating to a family. For example, a family of four, I'll use here, this as an example. And so really, part of it is really looking at containment. How are we going to manage the crisis? How resilient is this person? Resilience is a really important issue because resilience is about your bounce back factor. Are you self-aware? Are you psychologically aware of your personality? Do you know you overthink things? You know, there are many things that we look at. Are you a person that suffers from depression, for example? Or are you proactive with your negative thoughts? Everybody's got negative thoughts. So during this time, everybody's got negative thoughts. Let me just say that.
Mark, let's bring you in here. I mean, the idea that a generation before, a generation or two before this one, that you would have a job for life, that no longer exists, does it?
No, that's right. And it's been changing for some decades. The average Australian has been in their job for 3 years and 4 months. So that's not even a third of the way, or about a third of the way towards long service leave. We just move jobs more frequently. Some of that is moving on, you know, where it's a restructuring by the employer, but some of it is voluntary. So people are used to moving on. And I think the big shift is no longer is it no job for life, but there's not even an industry for life now. People have to retrain and upskill and be prepared to move out of a different career than they were headed just to remain future-proofed.
But that's very difficult for some people, especially in the car manufacturing business, where they have specific skills and they're a certain age. It's very, very hard to retrain.
That is true. And it's in some areas, it's even harder, some regional areas, because if you look, for example, the areas in South Australia that have the highest unemployment, North Adelaide, or in Victoria, the highest unemployment, Western Melbourne, they are also the areas where the number one industry by employment is manufacturing. So they don't have as many options. It's all very well to say, you know, move to something else. But if there's not the employment base there, there's an extra challenge.
Talk a little bit about the shift in industries. You know, we're seeing manufacturing sort of fall apart in Australia. The same's happening in textiles as well. What should people be doing beyond preparing their resume who know that their industry might be coming to an end?
Well, I think it's looking at where the growth opportunities are, and right across Australia now we're seeing growth in construction. We're seeing now the professional industries in the top five industries Australia-wide. 3 decades ago, the top five industries were all industrial. Now 3 of the top 5 are professional. You've got scientific, you've got technical, you've got finance, of course. So there are growth opportunities there for people. Probably means getting a degree if they haven't got that sort of study, or just at least being prepared to alter where they're headed, maybe even move to another area to find those opportunities.
Can I just say something about skills? Just because you're in manufacturing, understand that you have a skill set. These skills are transportable to other industries. Do not think, I'm stuck in manufacturing, so I'm a loser. Understand that your skills are really valuable and that they are transportable to other industries.
Great advice. Thanks so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Well, soon we'll find out whether an asteroid headed our way will spare us Earthlings.